Hello, everyone. This video is for anyone who is a patent searcher or who may one day be called upon to do a patent search, because one of the best ways to do a patent search is to use Dialog. This will be a general overview and introduction to what patents are all about. We'll start with what a patent is, how patents are obtained, and what the criteria are for obtaining one. We'll talk about the purpose of what's called a prior art search and a little bit about the patent records themselves. Because when you understand the basics of why you're doing a patent search, then you'll know what you're looking for and you'll get better results. And hopefully enjoy yourself along the way when you're exploring the many patent databases on Dialog. So let's get started. Here is one definition of a patent. It's from the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office. A patent is a government license. It's for a limited period of time, and it gives the patent owner the right to keep others from making, selling, or using the invention. And that's the important part of it, because after all, you can invent something and sell it without getting a patent. The purpose of getting a patent is to keep other people from using your idea. Patents, as you may know, are a huge business in the U.S. and elsewhere. For many large companies, their intellectual property portfolio is their single most valuable asset. But patents are also interesting, I think, for what they show us about inventors and about people. For every invention you find in the patent databases, and some of them are very unusual, there's some person or some company who thought that this idea would be their ticket to fame and fortune. So I like to think that in searching the patent databases, you can explore not only the worlds of business and technology, but also the limits of human imagination. This image here, for example, is from a patent called Combination Vacuum Cleaner and Artificial Dog. The idea was that if your dog is afraid of the vacuum cleaner, well, what you need is a vacuum cleaner cleverly disguised as a dog. So it's a stuffed dog with a vacuum cleaner built into it. This is what I mean about the patent databases. Everything you find in there was someone's vision for the next big idea. So what kinds of things can you patent? The USPTO, for example, says it can be a process, a machine, something manufactured, or a composition. That would include chemical compounds and pharmaceuticals. It goes so far as to say that these subjects take in practically everything that is made by man and the processes for making them. But there are limits. Notice that this definition does include the requirements that the invention has to be something new and useful. It's often said that to be patented, your idea must be novel, useful, and non-obvious. This, by the way, is a Valentine that was created by the U.S. Patent Office. The usefulness requirement nowadays is almost taken for granted. This is a patent for a novelty ski hat. It's kind of a variation on Steve Martin's arrow through the head gag, and it makes it look like you have a ski pole impaled through your head. And the patent says that its usefulness lies in producing amazement and wonder of how an individual can live with a ski pole going through the center of his head, unquote. So the usefulness test sets the bar pretty low, and the patent examiner will mainly be applying the novelty test. And it's your job as a patent searcher to find out whether or not the patent idea is new, or if it is already out there somewhere, because if it is, you're going to have trouble getting a patent. Looking again at the USPTO site, and other patent authorities are similar, your invention cannot be patented if it is already patented, or if it was described in a published patent application. That's here as number two, and that one should be pretty obvious. But you also cannot get a patent if your idea was described anywhere else that's available to the public, or if it's already being sold or used. And these two things together make up what patent searchers call prior art. Is the idea already out there, either as a patent or as anything else that's publicly available? And in my opinion, these two things show why ProQuest Dialog is an especially valuable tool for prior art searching, because you can search both for patents all around the world and also search for all kinds of non-patent literature in science, engineering, biomed. Also in the news and learned papers like dissertations, all kinds of articles, all on one platform using ProQuest Dialog. So the test, in plain words, is whether the idea is already out there, and the PTO says examples could include presentations at meetings, trade shows, lectures, YouTube videos, websites. The European Patent Office says that prior art could include a prehistoric cave painting or something that doesn't even physically exist yet, as long as it has been described. They even use the words anything can be prior art. So when you're searching for whether something can be patented, you want to cast your net wide. You want to search both broad and deep. And we have all kinds of databases that you can use for that. But today we're going to concentrate on searching for patents. So let's take a look at the patenting process. This chart is simplified, but it shows how you start out by doing your own novelty search or prior art search. That's where ProQuest Dialog comes in. Then you draft your application and file it with the patent office. The patent examiner does his own search. Hopefully they don't find anything that you missed. Then there may be some correspondence back and forth between the applicant and the patent office. Some changes might be required. These steps are sometimes referred to as office actions. And if all goes well, you'll get your patent. And it's not shown here, but in most cases, before the actual patent comes out, the patent office will publish your application as what's sometimes called a pre-grant publication, or PGP, or simply a published application. And those records are also a part of what you'll find in the patent databases on ProQuest Dialog. And that's the basic process. Sometimes there are variations on this. In the U.S., for example, if you don't want to start out with a fully developed patent application, you can file what's called a provisional application. That's a little quicker and easier to prepare, and it sort of plants your flag. It proves that you had the idea. But if you start with a provisional application, you'll need to follow that up, I believe, within a year with a regular patent application. And it's usually about 18 months after your regular U.S. patent application is filed that it gets published as a pre-grant publication. So, what does a patent record include? There's what's called a bibliographic section, with things like the title, the application and publication numbers with the dates, the assignee, or in other words, the owner or the applicant, and the inventor's name. There are a number of class codes used to identify the type of technology involved. These can be used for searching as well. Then there's the actual text, which will include an abstract or a short summary. The claims, which is the part that legally describes exactly what it is you're trying to patent. And there are detailed specifications, which expand on all that. Each of these areas can be searched separately or in any combination using the field codes in ProQuest Dialog. There may be images and a patent family, which we'll talk about in a bit, but basically it's a group of patents that are related to each other, either because they're basically the same patent in different countries, or because they share some, if not all, of the same application numbers, cited as priority, or previous applications that the applicant is relying upon in addition to the current application. And there may be legal status information showing things like if the patent has been reassigned, bought and sold to a new owner, or if other things have happened to it legally, like it's been terminated for failure to pay a maintenance fee. Some of our databases have all of this information, while some have just parts of all this, so you can learn more about all of that in our separate video called Patent Databases on Dialog. I've mentioned patent families, and sometimes you'll want to see not just a particular patent, but also the whole group of patents that are related to it, either because they're essentially the same patent issued in multiple countries, or because they're more broadly related by some partial crossover of the applications that they cite as priority. Patent families are created by different methods depending on the database. So again, this is something you can learn more about in the video, Patent Databases on Dialog. So I hope you'll check that out. So that's it. A general introduction to patents, just to give you some background and context that may help to enhance your experience of searching for patent-related materials on Dialog. If you'd like more information, here are some additional resources. And if you have any questions or need help, you're welcome to call the help desk at these numbers, or you can email us at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.